This is going to represent ego and status. And that's what they're for. That's what a nice watch is for, right? So this is ego and status. You wait right here. I got something else. This bowling ball. See, this is going to represent fate. Please don't hurt me. Now, it's very simple. I got one other object here so we can do a little juggling, and this is a ping pong ball, and this is going to represent chance. So here's life, right? You got fate, you got status, you got chance, and you got to take risks to win. You know that. I'll teach you something about the risks. So you ready? Okay, stretch out on the floor right now. Yeah, lay down. Go ahead, lay down on your back. Go ahead, stretch out. Stretch out, buddy. Stretch out. There you go. Stretch out out there, hands on your sides. I'll make a little pillow for you. This is carpeted, but it's wood. Oh, sorry. I need this. Okay. Sorry. Yeah. There you go. I'm okay. I'm okay. Well, yeah, you can put your hands anywhere you want. I smell fear.
Not me.
Oh. Now you comfortable? You good? Now, before we actually do this, I'm going to perform the entire trick once in my imagination. You got to give me just a second. You understand? One moment, please. Okay. This will be over before you know it. All right. Wish me luck. Better hope they applaud really soon. Yeah! Did it! There, you did it. Fabulous. Woo! Fabulous. Excellent. I'm going to ask you one question. One question, and then you get to go sit down. One question. When you were lying down on the stage, you weren't thinking about the watch, were you?
Nope.
Hell no. Give him another round of applause, will you? Thanks, buddy. Now, do you know why Darren was not thinking about ego or status when he was lying down there on the stage? He had a little perspective. Ego and status are great. They're great. I mean, it's fun. It feels like really important stuff. But what really, really counts? You're here. You're here. You have your health. You have this moment. That's all you ever had. And when you remember that's all that counts, then you can risk ego and status. And when you can make those risks, you can win big time. Would you say that this is an ordinary deck of cards? Ordinary, absolutely ordinary deck of cards. Yes. Oh, they're a little big. Oh, well, nothing gets past you, does it? You know, that's good. That's good. You could be an executive. Did you know that? That's good. I'm teasing you. But other than that, they're big. They're all different and all that good stuff. Okay. So here's what you have to do. You have to hold this. This is a penny, and this is a part of the whole deal. So hang on to that, and we're going to do a little experiment. A little experiment. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to select a card from out of the deck and show it to everybody but our experimentee. What's your name, sir?
Rad.
Okay, Rad? Right. Now, you need to kind of turn around for a second and face it back while I show everybody else a card. And don't peek. It's not a joke. Actually, a lot of people peek because they think, oh, well, it'll be funny. And it's not. There's a time for kidding around, and there's a time for being serious. Right now, we're going to be serious for just a moment. When we're kidding around, you'll know that we're kidding around. But right now, we're just going to... Okay, we're just going to be serious for a moment here. And don't, if you're not looking, don't let them look. Can everybody see? Everybody sees the card. Okay, all right, here we go. Go ahead and face me now, concentrate. Here's what we're going to do. Concentrate on the card, and I will give you a little tip. It's not a hint, it's a tip. Don't try to think of the number and the suit at the same time. Because what happens, sometimes I'm thinking of the suit while you're trying to get the number, or vice versa, you know. So what we're going to do, we're going to split it in half. We'll just work on the number first, just the number. Now, is a card that I'm holding in my hands right now, is this a high card or is it a low card? Okay, first of all. Concentrate on the number of the card. And I'm only going to give you 3 tries, and I think that's fair. I don't think this is, I'm sending you a mental image of the card. 3. Okay, 3. All right. Now, this is a difficult part. Relax and open up your mind. Relax. Relax. Open up your mind. I'll give you a hint. It's red and it's heart-shaped. Concentrate. Do you have any idea what the suit is? The 3 of hearts! You're wrong! A mistake! It's a mistake! And look, it's not a disaster. It's not a disaster to make a mistake. In fact, it's even kind of funny. Especially when it's not us, and it's just some schmuck like this guy. So what's the big deal? Why are we so afraid of mistakes? Because they cost us. That's what you say. Oh, it's going to cost me. And it is. It's going to cost you. May I? Yeah. It's going to cost you this. This penny. But this is a very special penny because it buys you something. It buys you a little bit of wisdom. And that's what mistakes are for. See, you don't make mistakes, you spend them. You spend them on learning things. And a lot of people go through life like very wealthy misers. They're rich in unspent mistakes, and they're very poor in experience. So next time you think you can't afford a mistake, it's all it is. You can afford. You can afford this mistake. And if you really think you can't, you can borrow one from our friend here. He's got a lot of them. Give him a big round of applause, will you? Thank you so much for helping. Very cool.